After prostatectomy or removal of the prostate, erectile dysfunction is inevitable if you don't take immediate reaction. And it shouldn't come as a surprise to you, but the prostate is intricately involved in the erectile process. Now, as a matter of fact, it is a huge part of stiffness, rigidity, and that lock and load phase, right? So when the prostate is in trouble, imagine a slingshot without elasticity. Now, it's believed that about 70% of men who have BPH or an enlarged prostate will have ED. So if you have issues with the prostate, you're more likely to have low libido, trouble getting hard, and lower sexual satisfaction. Now that's how important the prostate is. That's why I talk so much about it. So I'm Dr. Rachel Ross, functional medicine doctor, and my goal here is to help you optimize without a bunch of prescription drugs. Now I help you focus on natural strategies to help you biohack your body. And the way that ED sets in after prostatectomy or prostate removal or prostate surgery is very similar to the way that ED sets in whether it's age-related or chronic disease-related erectile dysfunction. So I'm gonna take you and I'm gonna show you today the number one way for you to combat age-related ED and prostatectomy-related ED. Now, I'm gonna show you the science behind why we think ED sets in and how you can very easily, without drugs or medication, fight against this natural decline and improve oxygenation, improve blood flow, improve stiffness, and you're going to learn today how to kind of think a little bit outside the box. And I promise you it'll be worth it because it may not be what you expect. It's not going to be a drug. It's not going to be something that you need to take or that you need to get a prescription from me for or that you need to DM me for. You can start this actually today so that we can get that blood flow moving again. So what if I told you that there is this way to bring the blood flow back, to help bring erectile function back to where it used to be? Now imagine getting this back, getting stiff again, all without really needing to use drugs or without wondering whether you're gonna get one or not. So I wanna introduce you to two different cellular processes that you may or may not have heard from, right? So the first one that I wanna talk to you about is called apoptosis. Now, what apoptosis is basically like throughout this whole erectile tissue, we have what are called tiny blood vessels within the corpora. And so if you look here to this diagram over here, what you'll see is the corpus cavernosum and the corpus spongiosum. Embedded within the corpus cavernosum are what we call cavernosal blood vessels and nerves, and they are the most important aspect of an erection. And when we're talking about these two cellular processes that I'm going to go through, they actually act to destroy this tissue and remove the ability for you to expand and stay hard the way that you used to. So these tiny blood vessels and nerves, the corporal nerves, they are actually embedded within the tissues. And so these corporal nerves are intricately wrapped around the prostate. So if some type of damage occurs to the prostate or surgery occurs to the prostate or even BPH, those nerves can actually get damaged, right? So imagine a ball with a cluster of nerves around it, and then those nerves actually start to penetrate through to the erectile tissue. Those are your cavernosal nerves. Those are the nerves that actually get damaged when someone has a radical prostatectomy, whether they tried to spare the nerves or not. And also just in life, as BPH starts to take growth, sometimes we see these nerves getting damaged. Now, as the cells from the nerve start to get damaged, and this happens too, all our cells can actually get damaged. And that's a natural part of life, right? We go out, there's some toxins, our cells get damaged. But our body is supposed to be designed to combat that damage, slow that damage down, and to repair the process. What happens when the prostate is in trouble like this and cell death is happening is that the cell death is happening at a rate that's not conducive to survival and thriving of this tissue that ultimately becomes so important, right? So as the nerves from this tissue start to die off, their ability to control and signal those arteries to relax and bring blood flow in becomes impaired as well. So we've got impaired nerves, we've got impaired blood vessels, and the interesting thing is that as you age or after an injury, or certainly after radical prostatectomy, your body starts to experience this death, right? The cell death. And what we want to happen is we want those cells to be repaired. And because if not, you have a reduction in the smooth muscle and the blood cells start to have trouble moving blood flow through. So you have decreased stiffness and decreased blood flow. Now, let me just tell you that cell death is actually a normal part of life. It's something that we call apoptosis. You need cells to die and turn over and new healthy cells to come, right? You want your body to say, hey, these are damaged cells. Let's get some new ones in there. But unfortunately, sometimes with cell death or apoptosis, this cell death can actually be accelerated. Right? And so just like anything that dies, right? If you have a fish tank and all the fish die, you got to clean it up, right? So what happens is then we have something called autophagy. And autophagy is basically your cell's way of kind of cleaning up this process of cell death. So the apoptosis is the cell death, but autophagy actually kind of controls, you know, it turns on cell death and it can slow down cell death. So autophagy is also a really great thing. You want your cells to be able to do that, but what we're finding is in people who have radical prostatectomy or even the basic aging of life down there, what we actually find is that this process is happening too fast. So the cells are dying off too fast, and the autophagy system is basically going high speed, and the turnover is too much. So that's actually, cell death is actually why you start to see the shrinkage, right? This is actually why you start to notice that not only is it not working the way you want it to, the tissue has actually atrophied. So now accumulating evidence has indicated that this apoptosis process, especially that in the smooth muscle of cells of the corpus cavernosum, plays a huge role in that decrease in volume, to the fact that the veins stop working, and to erectile dysfunction. So what we want to do is we want to come up with the number one way that we can slow this process down and reverse it. We can actually program the cells to say, hey, you know what? Let's slow this process down and let's be a little bit more strategic about which cells die and which ones stay alive, right? So autophagy is the cleanup and the programming, and apoptosis is actually the cell death, right? So, when we're just to reiterate, this process is part of what helps us prevent cancer, apoptosis and autophagy. But when it goes wrong and when the programming isn't right, that's when trouble starts to happen. And when it comes to erectile issues, this is the main cause, the underlying cause. You know how I always talk about get to the underlying cause? This is one of the main underlying cause of not just ED that's related to the prostate, but ED that's related to trouble with the androgens or the testosterone, and ED that's related to nerve and blood flow related issues. Scientists seem to think that this is the number one process. So in general, mild autophagy protects cells from death, whereas severe and rapid autophagy always causes cell death. So interestingly, recently a large number of studies have decided and determined that this is the number one cause of erectile dysfunction and diabetes, deteriorating age, and testosterone deficiency. So we know what the problem is. So now let's talk about the solution. What can slow this down, put the brakes on the cell death, and start to regenerate? What can help reprogram this whole situation? Pumping, pumping, pumping. Now, pumping has been shown to help repair the cavernous nerves. that have been injured and help stop slow death and apoptosis. Yes, all of that. And instead, it encourages what I call slow autophagy, not the rapid kind. So think of it kind of like a Pac-Man, right? So remember Pac-Man, he just gobbled up damaged cells that got in the way. So we want to slow that process down and help them slow down a little bit so that they can actually start to repair instead of destroy. Now, pumping actually uses negative pressure to increase the blood flow, the arterial inflow into the penile tissue, and actually improve cavernosal blood flow. So let's be clear. Let's go back to our picture here. So many studies have demonstrated that after radical prostatectomy, there's unavoidable nerve injury. And pumping can actually help reverse that and bring cavernosal oxygenation. So bring oxygenation and blood flow to the area. So what science thinks is that it exerts its effect by a similar nitric oxide cascade signaling pathway, that CGMP pathway we talk about when we're talking about the blue pill. And it causes the corpus to relax and the nerves to start to reprogram and regulate a variety of these activities. So at the end of the day, the pumping can help improve blood flow, help repair blood cells, and early use of vacuum therapy for radical prostatectomy has not only the potential to restore spontaneous erections, but it can also help you maintain the length and increase penile hardness. What else could you ask for? And an increasing number of studies showed that vacuum therapy can preserve erectile function, preserve it, and repair this process of overexposed, overzealous program death. Now, when we talk about pumping, I actually have a couple favorite pumps, and what we'll do over the next few videos is I'll kind of review some of them for you so that you can see the differences between them. Because honestly, studies are indicating, life is indicating, when I work with gentlemen, one of the first things that we do is get a good quality pump, is that it can restore things in a way that just popping a pill cannot. Now, there are some benefits to certain pills and certain herbal remedies, but when you invest in a quality pump for yourself, you are actually taking it to the tissue level, if that makes any sense, right? You're going straight to the thing. You're going straight to the issue, right? It's kind of like going to the doctor. You hurt your leg and you're trying to figure out, well, why is the doctor asking me if I have a headache? I promise you it's all connected, but if he'd have just focused on the leg questions, you would have felt like it was a more thorough examination, just because maybe you don't see the connection there. So the pump gets you straight to the topic, which is how can I repair this tissue that has been damaged? Now, when I talk about how to pick a quality pump or my favorite pump is going to be the Vaxate, because what I like about the Vaxate is it not just uses air, but it also uses water as a means to help in this rehabilitation process. And I find that even their studies indicate that when they survey patients after they've started using it, the patients and the partners seem to feel as though the side effect is an increase in size. So who wouldn't want that side effect? But I also like about it because it actually incorporates the use of warm water. And what warm water does, even before, you notice how sometimes if you get a massage or if you go to physical therapy, they put warm, moist compresses on the area because it allows the tissue to stretch and accommodate more, right? Well, it's the same with pumping. I feel like with a hydro pump, and of the Vaxate in particular, you have the actual opportunity to actually have warm water and air helping with this process. So next week, I'm going to actually show you one of my favorite pumps that actually doesn't involve water too, because I want you to have a variety of different options. But for those of you who are ready to just dive in and to have a discreet version of it, the Vaxate is great for that. And of course, I have some more videos on the Vaxate below because I believe very strongly in this as part of the rehabilitation process. So at the end of the day, The doctor may share with you something's going on with your prostate, or you may start to feel it. You may have the symptoms, or you may have decreased ejaculate. Whatever the process is, I feel as though if we could actually even start guys earlier using the pump, it would help prevent some long-term issues. Don't overpump though. So we'll talk about that on another time. So like this video, share this video. And this is what I do here. I help you optimize in natural ways that doesn't require a prescription.